Hello everyone, this is DarkSorrow446 here, and welcome back to Let's Play Alice Mass Returns. Last time, we managed to arrive here at the Hatter's Domain after crash landing through a wall here. And we managed to get a new dress. The Steamstress dress, if I remember correctly. Oh man, I actually like this dress. I like the steampunk vibe coming from it. The reason why we're here back at Hatter's Domain from the last game is to try and talk to the Mad Hatter and see what is exactly going on in the Wonderland here. So, Blimey, I am sorry for the short episode in the last one because I was a little bit short on time and I was sort of busy. So, yeah, sorry for the short episode last time, but this will probably be a normal length episode, so don't worry about it. So, Blimey, let's go ahead and head to the Hatter's Domain, shall we? And I'll admit, the Hatter's Domain has to be probably one of my favorite areas in this game. Because, I just like the aesthetics of it. I like the look of it. It's very interesting. Let's go ahead and get through it and try to collect everything that we can. I am 100% in this game. So let's just go ahead and see what we can do. And hello, buddy. What are you doing? Hello, little madcap. What are you doing over there? I saw you jump. And I'm not for sure why you're attacking me, but you're in my way, so. It's me because you're mad. That's probably the case. Whoa, that fork dropped out of nowhere. Well, there's an invisible platform here, so let's try and jump on it. There we go. And I probably missed. Yep, I missed. But good thing I don't necessarily die when I miss a platform. So that's good, I guess. Try to jump over. Come on. Dang, I missed. This is what I get for being impatient. Well, actually, let's get up to higher ground. That's probably a better case. Yeah, there's a ball right over in this direction, so let's try to get. Oh, there. I saw you move at the last second, but thank God I made it. Let's keep shrinking to keep to know where I am. There we go. Let's head over here and see that snout distance, so let's just shoot it. I just shoot the crap out of it. Come on. I'm going to wait. There we go, because my pepper grinder is about to overheat. So anyway, shoot that snout and get this vent up here. There we go. And let's just get on this steam vent and how we get this bottle over here. There we go. There is an achievement for this game for literally staying on one of these vents for literally 7 minutes. It's kind of a stupid achievement. It's very easy to miss, but there you go for those who are achievement hunters. So just stay on that vent for 7 minutes and you'll get venting frustration, which is the achievement for this game. I'll admit it's a very stupid achievement to get, but hey, that's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to stay in the vent for 7 minutes and there you go. And I got to see some more of those madcaps over there. So I actually just go ahead and shoot the crap out of you. And they do dodge out of your way out of your pepper grinder shots, but since we cornered them on a small platform here, they're very easy to get out the pepper grinder. So there we go. Well, I just keep moving along now. And oh man, what the heck is this place? Some sort of dodo butcher shop, I'm guessing. Definitely, before we hit that switch, we actually want to head over here and destroy these crates and vases where they are. And shrink down this violet and get some teeth and shrink down this hole. I just love this dress. I'm sorry, but I'm a very big fan of the dress changes in this game. Because, look at it. They just look so good. I just love the steampunk look of this dress. I'm sorry. There's many more dresses in the game that we'll get later on that pales in comparison to this dress, but the Steamstress dress is probably one of my favorite dresses in the game. So let's just go ahead and move along now and press the switch. There we go. And I forget what the Steamstress dress does. I believe that's something to do with not teeth, but I think breakables, I think you can get more teeth from breakables, that's what this dress does. And it's like a roasting dodos here for some reason. Poor little dodos. They get so abused in the Alice in Wonderland universe. And, oh, hello, hi. Did not see you there, good sir. And, nope. You're not hanging me today for your giant fork, good sir. Like, come on. There we go. There we go. That takes care of them. Yeah, I mean, as I was saying, I mean, those get very abused in the Alice in Wonderland universe. Not for sure why. I mean, they get used as, I mean, they get very abused a lot in this universe for some odd reason. Definitely, was that all that was in there? Really? Just for those teeth and just a amount of blood and seeing some very disturbing does hanging from the ceiling? And, hello, did not see you here before. That's interesting. I miss a slithering ruin here. That was interesting. Definitely, I just keep moving right along and I'll just shoot you from a distance. There we go, kill you. And that guy was about to strike me, so that's why I dodge out of the way and kill you. There we go. And there's another one around here. Alright, there you are. Hi, just shoot you from distance here. Break your little hat and kill you. There we go. And just smash these boxes. There we go. Just get some more teeth. Ah, we're getting actually close to upgrading the pep grinder, which is actually really nice. And then I just turn this switch and get a steam vent. And there we go. There it is. And I just get on that steam vent. Head up. Alley-oop. There we go. And I believe there's actually another thing we can get here. And I think that's the way we're supposed to go over there. Well, anyway, I jump on this moving gear carefully. And I see you over there, buddy. You're not knocking me off. I don't think so. You know what I mean? I'll admit, the floating villain, I actually have a thing for floating buildings. I mean, it's just aesthetically pleasing to me. I mean, I just like the design of Hatter's Domain in general. Well, I think we're supposed to glide back over there. No, wait, is that the way we already went? Yes, it is. Never mind. What am I thinking? I think that's the place we've already been to, but duh, we already been there. My bad. Broke a teacup for some reason. With these weird symbols on. And went, hi, little madcap, and goodbye. And, oh, yeah, a teapot in your head. Now it's gone. Well, these madcaps are like cyborgs, steampunkish cyborgs, just like the Mad Hatter. So that's a little bit interesting. Well, is that everything we need to get here? I mean, just shrink down just to make sure. Okay, let's just keep moving on then. Let's get on this vent here. And wait for that platform to come back and just twirl around just to look and make it. There we go. There's any invisible platforms? Nope. Let's jump on this vent. Allie. Oh, thank God that was close. Anyway, there's a whole bunch of enemies that'll show up here and we need to be careful here. Hello! And wrong button, and there we go, just keep shooting you. I knew it! Shield cap is right behind me. That's what I call those guys, shield caps. And I just slice the hell out of you and done! Ah, oh, I pressed the button! Come on, game! I pressed the button, don't act like I didn't. Yikes, that was close. And I just kill you and yikes! And I got me in the backswing. And yikes! Ah! Well, I dodged! Come on! Game! Come on! Jesus, guys are accurate! I died! What the heck? I never died to those guys! Well, then again, I have been off this game for a while, so it... errors are inevitable, I guess. And plus, come on! I was dodging for some of those attacks! Come on! I mean, it's like my controller is lagging a bit. Like, seriously. What the hell? I should not have died to these guys. And plus, that one guy trying to get in the way of me shooting this guy. And I just, come on, Pepper Grinder. There we go. And I just try to kill these shield guys when we can't. And plus, the Alice's auto-targeting is not very good. And I dodged that time. I pressed that button. Yikes! Let me just get rid of you. Come on, there, get rid of you. Guys, is it just me or the controls are lagging today. Like, seriously. Let me just kill you. There we go. And I see that slithering ruin. Die. Let me just ring around the rosy. You! Alice! Aim, please. This is so weird. The controllers were not this stiff before. Like, what the hell? I guess it's just because of my controller. Hey, come on, guy. Attack. There we go. Well, it was death one. I can't believe I died to these guys. I should not have died to these guys. Well, yeah, bring down that platform there, so that's good. But I have the thing we destroy here. There we go. Get some health back, and I think that's all we need to do here. Well, the music's still going on, so let's just move forward and kill some more enemies. And hello, and goodbye. Come on. Just take your pepper like a man. Come on, I dodged! It's like these enemies are suddenly, like, have auto-aim for some reason. I just keep them at bay here. Come on, I dodged! What the hell? Like, seriously. I know you guys can't see my controller, but seriously, I dodged from those attacks. For some reason, my controller is lagging. Like, what the hell? I dodged that! What the hell? I dodged that and it still hit me! What the heck is going on, game? What do you have against me? I should not have gotten hit by those enemies. Like, what the hell? What is your beef with me, game? And hi, Scrap Sculpture of Mad Hatter. Like, what the hell, game? Come on! I thought we were friends. Curse you, LP Gerson! Not now, Slithering Ruin! My god, I never had that happen to me before. Like, seriously, it's like the controller, the game lagged for some reason. And sometimes this game doesn't lag that badly. Which is weird. Well, I just make our way over here and heal up at the shrinking violet. There we go. Just healing my wounds. Letting the little flower tickle me back to health. I mean, seriously, I never experienced that before. Like, what the hell, game? It's like you have it out for me for some reason. Like, all of a sudden, the game has it out for me. It's not because it's my incompetence that time. It's because somehow the controller did not register my inputs, and those guys were very accurate for some reason. Let me just head here and get this memory.
My heart is open, Alice. Never closed. Never locked. It needs no key.
Okay, but why don't I just get this snout next? There we go, we should get a picnic basket here, I think. Yep, there we go. Let me just smash this and get ourselves some golden teeth. There we go, we almost got enough for the pepper grinder, which will leave me very happy. I think, yep, there's some invisible platforms here, so let's just mosey right along. There's nothing on that platform. Good. And is there anything else around here? Nope. Then I just keep on platforming. That was close. That was very close. Then I just get on this thing here. Head over here. There we go. Makes a very tight jumps here. Like, I'm doing good on the jumping, but not so much as the fighting as of late, which is so weird. Then I just go over here. Smash his box. There we go. So for some more teeth. Arrows, because we need, because why not? Let's turn this valve here. Getting ourselves in our vent. I believe there's something down there, and yep, there is. So I just, yeah, we can make our way back. So I just jump over here. Alley up. I think there's a shrink hole that we could, keyhole we could shrink inside. I think. No, actually, that's later on. Never mind. Then I got this little core here. Let's have some more mad caps, so let's deal with them. You're not killing me this time, buddy. There's only two of you this time. And ha-ha! No cheaping me this time. Not this time. And that time I dodged right in front of him, so that hit was expected. So then I got another little memory here, so let's recover that.
Rocks, Alice. A brick house like Gibraltar is impervious to fire, weather, and the indecencies of Barbary macaques, should the need arise.
Okay, that's interesting though. Why don't I just head back here? I think we got all the stuff that we know we need to get in there. Why don't I just jump over here on this vent and over here to this small platform and break this box. They're going, oh, that teeth fell. Dang it. Why don't I just get on this gear here? Come on. Made it. Nailed it. Why don't I just keep on moving here, and I believe there's a snout on behind this platform when we actually jump over here. Yep, there is, so I'm gonna just shoot the hell out of this little snout. Let's shoot the hell out of this little piggy. And get ourselves some goodies. And we get our location for our next bottle. There we go. Alley-oop, there we go. Alright, next bottle. The ball, I'm not sure if I said this before, but the balls are basically just concept art stuff. That's really all they are. Why don't I just jump down here? Alley-oop, and oh, I'm so close to upgrading to Pepper Grinder, which is actually great. Ah, there it is. There's a little keel that was remembering. It was a little bit onward. Don't want to get too ahead of myself. And come on now, let's get through the keel. There we go. And let's cover our next memory. Okay, I'm guessing that was a memory back when Alice is at the asylum. Oh, and also, back in the main title screen, I believe there's a little, I mean, I'm not for sure, I think for the game manual for this game, there's actually a little bit of a little journal for Alice's stay back in Relic Asylum. I mean, you can go back and read it if you guys want to, but it's a little bit interesting fact of, like, what was going on for Alice in the real world while she was in Wonderland back in the first game. So you should be able to re-up like what happened to her in the asylum and all that stuff during the first game. So, well, yeah, that's a little bit of interesting information for you guys. I thought you guys should know. Well, it's just a little snout down here, so I just deal with that. There we go. And there's a vent that show up there. And I just jump on this. Yep. And make that. There we go. Bring down this little keyhole there. How much on a roll these collectibles today? I say that now, and watch me miss one. There's a pen here. Yeah, unfortunately, her sister had to deal with grown-up stuff, so she didn't have much. She was very lonely as a child, which is unfortunate. So she had to create her own. She had to create her own friends. How are you doing on the everything? Ah, pretty good so far. We got half the bottles and more than half the snouts and almost, I think more than half of the memories, actually. So that's good. So then I just jump back on this vent here and glide back. There we go. And how are we doing on Tiefen? Whoa, loading game. And what? Nothing in these pots. Seriously? There we go. That's myself. And ah, just one tooth away. Come on. I want my upgrade pepper grinder. Come on, game. Right. Whoa. Hello. What the hell are you? iPod. Is that a chocolate iPod? Yes, it is. Right. For this Emmy, we have to, like, shoot him in the eye. So, we're going to shoot him in the eye and blind him a little bit. He can, when she's down, he can go up and smack him. That's basically the gist of these guys. Just shoot them, just blind them in the eye with the pepper grinder, and then just go and head towards them with the warble blade, and just slice the hell out of them that way. Lance has killed him, or the way's been opened. Ah, great, more of them. How unfortunate. Well, here we are at the lactation, I think that's what it's called. Lactation room, I'm guessing, or put milk and tea, I'm guessing. Well, I just. And also, these iPods can shoot you from a distance, so be careful of that. Like, yikes. I actually want to get rid of the Insidious Ruins first. There we go. Yikes. Honestly, the camera could be a little bit better and there's an iPod somewhere shooting at me, so I just. Oh, come on, I hit you. And actually, you know what? I should probably upgrade my Vorpal Blades right now since I can. Not my Vorpal Blade, the Pepper Grinder. There we go, make it level 2 so we can have a better rate of fire and maximum capacity, so my Nair's eyes closed. When I open up my, I got some non-clear eye for you. There we go. That enemy's dead. Where's the other iPod? Ah, it's over there. I don't think I can get him. And he's shooting hot tea at me, which is not cool, by the way. I just smash these things. I think we can get him by using this. Yep, let's only get that band. Don't shoot me for the love of God. There we go. Let me just shoot you in the eye and slash the crap out of you. Yeesh, there's a whole bunch of these iPods here. Shoot in the eye from distance and kill you. And let's deal with you next. There we go. Yeah, it's just where things get a little bit hectic with the enemies, but not too bad. Only I just slice the hell out of your eye there. Give you a bloody eye. Mechanical monstrosities that have blood in them. That's interesting, a little bit morbid. Well, there we go. We dealt with those iPods. There we go. Well, the way is now open. There we go. Nice way for the game to load, and let's continue on. And I believe that's everything we can get here, I think. I'm not very sure, but let's continue on anyway, just to be sure. And where does this go to? Lost and found. Okay, hey, Treasure Cat, what do you have to say? And hello. Assist with time.
Find him, or your own time may be short.
Oh, that's a nice little reference back to America McGee's Alice from the first game. That's a really nice reference, because if you guys watched my playthrough, he actually said that line. Well, let's see what else he has to say.
Rush yourself off, girl. The hatter shouldn't see you at your best after all.
Yep, don't want to give him some bad manners or anything like that. We have to look proper and all that. We gotta look our best to see him, because we haven't seen our good friend for a long time. Even though he majorly blew his head off in the last game. But I'm sure he pretty much forgives us at this point. Let's press this switch here. And this switch is sort of time, so let's just head try over as fast as we can. Do not touch that stream of tea, because that will kill you. That's a hot stream of tea, and it will kill you if you touch it. So that's why I didn't jump through it like an idiot. So let's just wait for this platform to raise back up, and I believe that's where you're supposed to go, but let's smash these things up and get some more teeth. There we go. And just glide over here. There we go. It's a good thing that Allison can glide now, unlike in the first game where it would have been useful, because you know how much I hate the platforming in that game. What? How did I get hit? There was no T in my path. Well, I'm guessing I probably clipped it a little bit, which is stupid. Come on. There's no way I see it now. I see it. It's very faint, but I see it. Fine, I'll go over here then. Fine, game. Be a jerk. Let's just jump over here now. And I believe, we have to make our way up there. So I'm going to just make through this tunnel here. And I believe there's an alternate path we can go to here, I think. And yep, there's a path we can make to right here, but we can't get to that just yet, or might be just another way around. Right here in this big room here, so that's just... Oh, here it is. We just shrink down right here, and head over our merry way this way, where we'll get to our next collectible, which is a golden bottle up there. Larry's our moody platform, so let's just be careful and make our way across them. We just wait on this little guy. There we go. And jump up here. And these platforms are numbered for some reason. I'm not very sure why. We're getting gold teeth out of it, so which is really good. Come on, jump up here. There we go. And alley-oop. There we go. We got our next bottle. There we go. And can I make it from here? Let's try it. There we go. Good thing my glide didn't run out, because that's a thing that can happen. You can't glide forever, unfortunately. It's because there is like an overheat for the glide for some reason. So that's a little bit unfortunate. Let's hit that switch and make our way up here. There we go. And Try and make our way through there. There we go. Before the doors close down on us. Let's pull this lever and open that door so we can move on. There we go. So let me just jump down here and avoid the hot tea. I mean, I like hot tea as much as the next guy, but this tea will kill me. And let me just try to get this tea as best we can. There we go. Just keep on sliding to our doom. Not really, it's just a order to progress. When near defeat, Menacing Ruin becomes enraged. Dodge to avoid being rammed. Heed the cat. He offers hints to those in need. Sometimes. But most of the time he just offers, like, some casual conversation. Warwin. Hello, what the heck is that? You, my little bunny rabbit thing, are glowing. Clockwork bomb. Let's pick it up. Some walls and floors are weak and can be destroyed. Place a clockwork bomb near the weak surface. Then they need the clockwork bomb to destroy the weak surface. Yeah, this is where we get our new, quote-unquote, weapon of the game. The clockwork bomb. Which basically help you, like, destroy, which can help you destroy stuff. Granted, it also has some uses in combat, which could make it, I mean, the clockwork bomb does, we can use a clockwork bomb to, like, destroy surfaces like this, and, like, a timer will go off, but we can set off manually like that, so. Alright, there we go. But it also has some applications in combat, which can be used to, like, distract enemies and all that stuff. But it can actually damage enemies quite a bit, but not that much. So they'll go relying on it too much. But there is an achievement for this game where we actually, like, use it to, like, hit enemies and all that stuff. And I fell, which is unfortunate. I mean, yeah, it doesn't do too a lot more damage. Doesn't do a lot of damage to enemies. So, and I am not holding the Vorpal Blade. Now it's just acting like she is. Which is weird. Let me just keep moving forward here. And, there's a door over there, but before we go into that, let's actually head over here and smash your stuff. Get inside its keel, come on. And get our last memory for this episode.
We'll roast in our beds, Alice, for the sake of your father's unnatural devotion to printed paper. This horde of flambles wants only a malignant spark, and poof, our flesh and blood is smoked.
Well, that's a little bit morbid to say. That's a little bit morbid what to say to your kid. Jesus. Never mind. The door that says Lil here, it's on fire on the inside. So let's go inside and investigate, shall we? Let's see what's on the other side.
Was a fire trap. A conflagration waiting to happen.
Okay, I'm guessing that was a memory. And we got some sort of weird key from that. Hit the high pots with a nasty surprise using the clockwork bomb. That's interesting to know, I guess. Hi! Hello, and when Alice's health is low, hysteria becomes available. Air hysteria by pressing L3. While in hysteria, Alice cannot be hurt and will inflict more damage. Be careful, hysteria only lasts for a limited time. Yep, this is basically get our invincibility mode of the game. Where we go, all hysterical on their asses! Yeah, but this is our super mode. When we're on one road left, We can become hysterical and literally slash the crap out of the enemies and almost kill them instantly. And this is our best way to actually get roses. So I'll be using hysteria a lot when I get low on health. And there is an achievement for only using hysteria once in the game, but since I already platinum this game anyway, I'll just use it like normal. This seems like a good way to end off the video, which is us hysterically slicing hell out of those enemies. But anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. And if you guys did, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe, anyway. I'll see you guys next time. This is Dark Sora 446 signing off. See you guys next time. Bye. Yeesh, can you believe how everything went black and white and all bloody when we went in hysteria? Like, Jesus. Remind me not to piss Alice off.